Good day, everyone, and welcome to Module 6 presentation entitled Human Sexuality. So before I proceed to discuss this discussion, I just want to discuss first the introduction to human sexuality. Sexuality is an essential and integral part of all stages of human life. Yet, the topic is still taboo, and almost every country talking openly about sexuality is crucial for understanding sexual behavior. The growth and the development of our bodies, how we experience our gender roles, what constitutes a healthy relationship, how to have children, when and if we want to, how to communicate with our intimate partners, and how to prevent health problems and unwanted pregnancies. Opening lessons should provide young people with both the words and the comfort to talk about sexuality, so they will participate more actively in class. And more important, so they will begin to develop skills for lifelong communication with parents, partners, health care providers, and eventually their own children. Opening lessons should also address values. True discussion of values will be relevant in many other topics. Although values are subjective and cannot be taught, sexuality educators can guide students to examine and clarify their own values and recognize how they powerfully influence behavior. Meaning to say, human sexuality involves sexual attraction to another person, which for the most part is to the opposite sex or the heterosexuality, some to the same sex, homosexuality, or some having both, bisexuality, or not being attracted to anyone in a sexual manner, or the asexuality. Let us proceed to gender and sexuality. Sex and gender are generally interchanged to mean the same thing, when actually they are different from each other. Sex does not simply refer to the sexuality activity, about the person's biological and psychological characteristics at birth. Everyone is born with a biological sex, a girl, boy, or intersex. Hormones, estrogen, and testosterone. Chromosomes XX and XY, genitals, vagina and penis, gonads, ovaries, and testicles, among others. Gender, on the other hand, is defined by our self-concept of sociocultural norms based on our biological sex at birth. Males are commonly perceived to have masculine, while females have feminine characteristics. For example, over the years, society dictates which jobs are more suited for men and women. Women are encouraged to take jobs in nursing, garments, electronic industry, and etc., while men tend to gravitate to relatively hard labor jobs, engineering, construction, and auto mechanic. Basically, gendered sexuality is the way in which gender and sexuality are often viewed as likened construction, whereby the role of gender in an individual's life is informed by and impacts others' perceptions of their sexuality. For example, both the male and female genders are subject to assumptions of heterosexuality. Otherwise, sexuality often refers to a person's sexual orientation or preference. Your sexual orientation is who you are emotionally, mentally, and physically attracted to. This may be same-sex, homosexual, male-to-female, heterosexual, or bisexual orientation, most gender. The importance of sexuality is an integral part of being human. Love, affection, and sexual intimacy contribute to healthy relationships and individual well-being. But along with the positive aspects of our human sexuality, there also are illnesses, mixed emotions, and unintended consequences that can affect our sexual health. Number two, sexuality, as said by the World Health Organization or WHO, an official definition, is a central aspect of being human throughout life and encompasses sex, gender identities, and role, sexual orientation, eroticism, pleasure, intimacy, and reproduction. Sexuality is experienced and expressed in thoughts, fantasies, desires, beliefs, attitudes, values, behaviors, practices, roles, and relationships. While sexuality can include all of these dimensions, not all of them are always experienced or expressed. Sexuality is influenced by the interaction of biological, psychological, social, economic, political, cultural, ethical, legal, historical, religious, and spiritual factors. Definitely, female sexuality has been a controversial subject that plays a crucial role in our everyday lives. There is a constant double standard women face. In terms of sexuality, both males and females are more similar than society deems them. It begins with parents. They have a great impact on how their daughters view sex and their own sexuality. Also, female sexuality is considered taboo when they become mothers. There is a never-ending battle of hypocrisy that women face when it comes to. Gender refers to the socially constructed roles, behaviors, expressions, and identities of girls, women, boys, men, and gender diverse people. It influences how people perceive themselves and each other, how they act and interact, and the distribution of power and resources in society. Gender identity is our own internal understanding of our gender, regardless of the biological sex we were assigned at birth. Sexual orientation is about who we are attracted to sexually. Both gender identity and sexual orientation exist on a spectrum, and anyone of any other, any gender identity can have any sexual orientation. In continuation to our discussion, I am now going to discuss the gender and social construction. Gender is a social construct. As such, gender is a part of the social structure of society. It speaks about the unequal power relations between women and men in culture and literature. By then, more enterprising, backlash from the country have locked the cities and eventually garnered recognition in society from their humble beginnings in working in beauty parlors. The entertainment and fashion industries, tomboys become known as efficient workers in factories and offices. 1980s, malayang kilusan ng bagong kababaihan, Makibaka, released a position paper acknowledging gender and sexuality issues as part of the women's and national liberation movement. In 1990s, the rise of LGBT consciousness emerged more strongly. The outlawed Communist Party of the Philippines, CPP, was first in recognizing the LGBT when it came out with policy documents recognizing the right of every individual to choose their gender in 1992. This drove the political activism of the LGBT community with the information, the Progressive Organization of Gays, and the Lesbian Collective. Next are the LGBT rights violations. The Philippine society and culture maintain much prejudice towards the LGBT community and lack basic sensitivity and recognition of the LGBT rights. Article 2, Section 11, and Article 3, Section 1, which purportedly guarantees full respect of the laws, but sexual orientation and gender identity are not explicitly crime. Watch over 173 hate crimes committed against members of the LGBT were documented since 1996. Mentioned laws, revised penal code, and other criminal laws. Also lacking in terms of punishing hate crimes, according to Philippine LGBT hate. It highlights the non-existence of comprehensive anti-discrimination law in the Philippines. People around the world face violence and inequality, and sometimes torture, even execution, because of who they love, how they look, or who they are. Sexual orientation and gender identity are integral aspects of ourselves and should never lead to discrimination or abuse. Human Rights Watch works for lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender people's rights, and with activists representing a multiplicity of identities and issues. We document and expose abuse based on sexual orientation and gender identity worldwide, including torture, killing, and execution, arrest under unjust law, unequal treatment, censorship, medical abuse, discrimination in health and jobs and housing, domestic violence, abuses against children, and denial of family rights and recognition. We advocate for laws and policies that will protect everyone's dignity. We work for a world where all people can enjoy their rights fully. Next is the inclusion of gender minorities. The outrage that resulted from the killing of Jennifer Laude, a trans Pinay or transgender woman, by a USA serviceman in 2014. The coming out of child star Isa Seguera as a transgender man and her eventually same-sex marriage to her partner Liza Dino in the United States are just example of how issues of gender and sexuality have become a controversial discussion in the Philippine society. It brings to the fore the issues of discrimination on the basis of sexual orientation and gender identity against the women and the LGBT. Gender minority individuals whose gender identity, man, woman, other, or expression, masculine, feminine, other, is different from their sex, male, female, against at birth.
So let's move forward. What are the effects of these gender roles on women and men? A consolidated anti-discrimination bill now pending in the Philippine Congress defines sexual orientation as the direction or emotional sexual attractions or conduct towards people of the opposite sex. Example of this is heterosexual or the same sex, called as homosexual, and for both sexes is bisexual. It is different from sexual behavior, which refers to the manner in which we experience and express our sexuality. It is also called sexual orientation is about our innermost concept of self as male, female, a blend of both, or neither. So according to the first statement, it talks about a new law being proposed in the Philippines that aims to prevent discrimination against people based on their sexual orientation. The law defines sexual orientation as the way a person feels emotionally attracted to others. It is also important to understand that sexual orientation is different from sexual behavior, because sexual behavior refers to how a person expresses their sexuality, while on the other hand, sexual orientation is about a person's deep-seated sense of themselves as male, female, a mix of both, or neither. The proposed law aims to protect people from discrimination based on their sexual orientation, which is an important step towards equality for all. And then we have next slide. Sexual orientation is distinct from gender identity. Many gay men do not necessarily feel that they are belong to the wrong gender, because gender identity refers to the people's sense of identity as characterized, among others, by manners. Example of this is the way how they dress themselves. Inclination and behavior in relation to masculine or feminine conventions. So according to this, based on our understanding, sexual orientation and gender identity are two separate things. Because sexual orientation is about who a person attracted to, such as being attracted to someone on the same gender or a different gender rather. Gender identity, on the other hand, is about person's internal senses of their own gender, whether they feel like a man, a woman, or something else entirely. Being gay or homosexual means being attracted to someone on the same gender, but it doesn't necessarily mean that a person feels like they belong to opposite gender. In other words, a gay man can identify as a man and feel comfortable with his masculine gender identity. And then we have gender identity. It's related to how a person feels and sees themselves as male, female, or non-binary. It involves more than just clothing or behavior, but includes one's sense of self and personal identity. And let's move on for the other terminologies for this topic. Then we have this transgender, which is term for people whose gender identity, expression, or behavior is different from those typically associated with their assigned sex at birth. Transgender is a broad term and is good for non-transgender people to use because trans is shorthand for transgender. Take note that transgender is correctly used as an adjective, not a noun. Thus, transgender people is appropriate, but transgender is often viewed as disrespectful. And then we have types of transgender. Transgender men. This term is for individual who are currently identifies as man. And then second type is transgender woman, a term for individual who currently identify as woman. And then the last type is the transsexual. It is a older term for people whose gender identity is different from their assigned sex at birth, who seeks a transition from male to female or female to male. Many do not prefer this term because it is known to sound overly clinical. And then we have cross-dresser. This is the term for people who dress in clothing traditionally or stereotypically worn by the other sex, but who generally have no intent to live full-time as other gender. The older term transvestite is considered derogatory by many in the United States. And then we have queer, a term used to refer to lesbian, gay, bisexual, and often also transgender people. Some use queer as an alternative to gay in an effort to be more inclusive. Depending on the user, the term has either the derogatory of an affirming connotation, as many have sought to reclaim the term that was once widely used in a negative way. And then the type of queer, we have the gender queer. This is the term used by some individuals who identify as neither entirely male or entirely female. And then we have gender non-conforming, a term for individuals whose gender expression is different from sexual expectation related to gender, bi-gendered. One who has a significant gender identify that compass both genders, male and female, some way feel that one side or the other is stronger, but both sides are there. And then we have two-spirit, a contemporary term that refers to the historical and current First Nation people whose individual spirit were a blend of male and female spirit. This term has been reclaimed by some in Native American LGBT communities in order to honor their heritage and provide an alternative to the Western labels of gays, lesbian, bisexual, or transgender. And also we have the FTM, a person who has transitioned from female to male, meaning a person who has assigned female at birth but identifies and lives as male, also known as transgender men. And then we have the NTF, a person who transitions from male to female. Also, the meaning for the person who assigned male at birth but identify and lives as a male, also known as what we call transgender woman. And then we have the sex reassigned surgery, this surgical procedure that changes one's body to better reflect a person's gender identity. This may include in different procedures, including those something also referred to as top surgery. Example of this is breast augmentation or removal, or bottom surgery altering genitals. Contrary to people believe there is one surgery, in fact, there are many different surgeries. These surgeries are medically necessary for some people. However, not all people want, need, or can have surgery as part of their transition. Sex change surgery is also considered as the derogatory term by many. And then we have transition, the time when a person begins to live as a gender with which they identify rather than the gender they were assigned at birth, which often includes changing one's first name and dressing and grooming differently. Transitioning may or maybe not also include medical and legal aspect, including taking hormones, having surgery, or changing identity documents. Example is the driver license, social security record to reflect one's gender identity. And also other medical and legal steps are often difficult for people to afford because it's costly, too much, a lot of money.
Our topic, intersex, a term used for people who are born with a reproductive or sexual anatomy or chromosomes pattern that does not seem to fit typical definition of male or female. Intersex condition are also known as differences of sex development. When you say intersex, is a general term used for a variety of situation in which a person is born with reproductive or sexual anatomy that doesn't fit the boxes of female or male. Next, drag queen, used to refer to male performers who dress as women for the purpose of entertaining others at bars, clubs, or other events. It is also sometimes used in a derogatory manner to refer to transgender women. A drag queen is a person, usually male, who uses drag clothing and makeup to imitate and often exaggerate female gender signifiers and gender roles for entertainment purposes. Historically, drag queens have usually been gay or men, and part of gay culture. Next, king. Used to refer to female performers who dress as men for the purpose of entertaining others at bars, clubs, or other events. Drag kings naman are mostly female performance artists who dress in masculine drag and personify male gender stereotypes as part of an individual or group routine. Next, D, understanding sexual orientation and gender identity and expression. SOGI is an abbreviation for sexual orientation and gender identity and expression. Just like we have genes, race, ethnicity, etc. as part of our identity, our SOGI is a significant phase of identity that can define who we are, influence our needs and experience. In countries like the Philippines, culture remain backward in many parts of the country. Our ideas of bakla, tomboy, transpinay, transpinoy, etc. are still dictated by religion, stereotypes, and occupational niches rather than genuine recognition of LGBT rights. When you say understanding sexual orientation, it is a person's gender identity may be the same as or different from their birth assigned sex. Gender identity is fundamentally different from a person's sexual orientation. Gender expression is how a person publicly presents their gender.
Because of globalization, solidifying under Western views has gained ground in the Philippines and is more popular among the middle class, while the larger base of LGBT are still unable to identify their identity and are often unrecognized by society. The proposed legislation uses our own social, culturally defined SOGI sexual orientation and gender identity. And lastly, I will discuss the LGBT community. The LGBT, lesbian, gays, bisexual, and transgender is a collective term for the community of diverse sexualities. They came from all walks of life, cutting across different social backgrounds, religions, and socio-political learnings. They have identified themselves to be part of the LGBT, but they are first and foremost LGBT that is also part of the oppressed and marginalized sectors. Peasant, workers, urban poor, and vulnerable sectors, persons with disabilities, elderly, indigenous peoples, migrant workers, and etc.